Hello everyone, I'm Rahul and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to see some interview questions on three-tier architecture. This video will be based on the practical scenario. First question is, what is a three-tier architecture? As you are able to see my screen, there are three layers in the architecture. First is presentation or web layer, which is a public layer where we place our web server, proxy, or load balancer. This layer is only for the interaction and not for the application. This layer passes the traffic to the next layer. This layer can be accessed over the internet and hence it may have few advanced devices to filter the incoming traffic. The next layer is called as application layer, where magic happens for every application. This is a completely private layer and cannot be accessed over the internet. Here, the main application is placed, which is actually serves the request and deliver the content. Then there is a last layer, which is a database layer. Application stores the data on this database and with the help of this database handles the request. This is also a private layer. Second question, how to create three-tier architecture in AWS? First of all, we'll create the VPC for underlying networking setup, which would be spanned across multiple availability zones. For the sake of explanation, we considered that the region has only two AZs. Next, we will create six subnets. Two subnets, which will be public for web layer. Then four subnets for app and database layers, which will be private. We will create EC2 instances to host our application, which will be in auto-scaling. Next, we'll create the database which will have multi-AZ enabled for high availability. Next, we will create the load balancer in web layer which will route the traffic to EC2 instances. The next question is, explain the network flow in the three-tier architecture. As we have seen the architecture, let's see the networking flow of the architecture. When the user will access the URL, the traffic would reach to the load balancer endpoint. Application load balancer will receive the traffic and as per the listener rule, it will route the traffic to application servers. The request would be served from the application using the database in backend. In this setup, we will have a single database which will be a writable database and all the servers from the auto-scaling group will communicate with this database. Fourth question, what would be the operational networking setup which is not exposed to the customers but required for operations like patching? The explanation which we have seen a while ago, that is for the customer network flow and not for the operational networking which is required for patching of the servers, downloading application related packages from the internet, or third-party integrations like payment gateways. This traffic would not use the same route which we have seen. Rather, we need a separate route to achieve this. Let's see that. By now, you would have known that the auto-scaling server are in app layer, which will not have internet access initially. So we need to use NAT gateway, which will be placed in the public subnet. Then we will route the traffic to the internet via this route gateway. Via this NAT gateway. But to make the NAT gateway work, we need to also deploy the internet gateway, which will route the traffic in the internet. Internet gateway is necessary in the network flow, which we have seen earlier. Using internet gateway, NAT gateway will be able to communicate with internet and load balancer will also able to serve the request over the internet. Fifth question. Why public subnet assigns a public IP to a server and private don't? I have seen many engineers think that the subnet is public because we have named it as public, but this is not the case. We all know that the subnet which will communicate with internet is a public subnet and the subnet which is not exposed to the internet directly is called as private subnet. But one point we should note that the subnet is always private when we create it and we need to enable the automatic private assignment by updating the subnet settings in action pane, which looks like this. Also, we need to create a route table which will route the traffic of this public subnet to the internet. Let's see the routes. Sixth question, what is private route? In the above image, we have app layer and its route table. Here, we are able to see two routes. One is for 0.0.0.0/0 and one is for 10.0.0.0/16. When we want to consider everywhere, we use 0.0.0.0/0, and if we want to add a specific CIDR, then we mention the exact CIDR, like we have 10.0.0.0/16. One point to note here is, we cannot add or remove the route which has target as local. This local route is configured by AWS and cannot be altered. Now what's this route does? This route means all the subnet in the VPC can communicate with each other without any special route. Second route, which is for everywhere, will route the traffic to NAT gateway. Here, please note one point. This 0.0.0.0/0 does not refer to the internet traffic. No. This means the traffic which is other than 10.0.0.0/16 or any other route. In other words, this is the traffic which is rejected by other routes. In this route, we can have private traffic as well, which is present with private source IP address. Eventually, this traffic would be rejected by the NAT gateway. I hope this is clear to you. If not, please comment below. Seventh question, what would be the routing for public traffic? As you are able to see the screen, we have two public subnet with route table. Here, I'll not explain the other routes, but one point is to note here is that the traffic other than destination IP with 10.0.0.0/16 would be routed to IGW, and IGW will transfer the traffic in the internet. Here, only the traffic will be routed to the internet which will have a public source IP address, and the traffic with private IP address will die. Eighth question. How the network logging can be configured in the VPC? Suppose we have a VPC, and to track the incoming and outgoing traffic, we can use VPC flow logs. We can collect the logs of all requests, approved request or rejected request in CloudWatch logs, S3 bucket in the same account, or we can also pass these logs to any other account S3 bucket. Also, we can pass it to Amazon Kinesis, so we can analyze the logs later for any troubleshooting. I hope you like the video. If you like the video, please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Also, please comment your feedback, which will help me to provide more valuable content. Thank you.